Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding Hello Lost in the Achhe Din, written by Pavan K. Verma. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Plus this is very important for Public Administration optional students, and this is also important from your essay preparation point of view. Now in order to properly understand this editorial, we need to know about what is meant by public office, and we also need to understand about of what kind of the democracy our country believes in pursuing. Now first of all, what is meant by a public office? Now public office is actually a governmental office. Public office, it is an embodiment of people's trust. It is an embodiment of people's faith. It is an embodiment of people's desire. And most importantly, it is an embodiment of people's dream and their wishes. So the public office, it has on its own self lot of responsibility to fulfill what the people wish, what the people desire, what the people want. And because of that, it is very important that this office, public office, it must sustain and it must uphold the credibility. It must be an embodiment of integrity. It must manifest propriety. It must manifest sanctity. Usko dikhana chahiye ki wo ek pure hai. It is white and there is no adulteration in it. But as far as today's editorial is concerned, it is about a kind of a misfeasance. It is also an example of malfeasance. Now these misfeasance and malfeasance, these are the deliberate acts done by the public holders for their pecuniary benefits, for monetary benefits. Now when public officials, they resort to such aberrations, they resort to such deviations, it leads to a loss in their credibility. And the people, they begin to feel disillusioned. The people, they begin to feel as harmed by such acts of the public holders. So in such a scenario, it becomes the utmost responsibility of these public holders to give away their seats. It becomes their responsibility to do away with such acts. Now, in order to understand the second aspect of this editorial, we need to understand about what kind of democracy our India is pursuing. Now, there are two kinds of democracies. One is a pseudo-democracy, the other is a substantive and a continuous democracy. Pseudo-democracy is confined to just the election of the leader. It has to do just with the election of a leader. Once you have elected him, the people, they will not be interfering. The people, they will not be resorting to processions. They will not be resorting to criticism. They will not be grinding the actions of the politicians. Ek bar chun liya, uske baad shanti. Log kuch bhi interfere nahi karenge, politician kuch bhi karta jaye. Now this was the kind of the democracy that India had been practicing till now. But of late, due to revolution in the education, due to revolution in the awareness, due to empowerment of the citizens, due to the factors of globalization and liberalization, the people, they have become more proactive. The people, they become more active. Now there is a transition that we are seeing. Now the transition is from the pseudo-democracy to the substantive democracy. Substantive is continuous, where the people will be criticizing the actions of the government on a continuous basis, where the people will be pushing the government to maintain and to to restore and to sustain its credibility. And if there is a tinkering with the credibility, they will put pressure on the governments to throw away those particular ministers. Now, this is a transition that we have seen in the people, in the citizens of India. But as far as the public holders are concerned, they are still stuck with the old inertia. Old inertia means they think that they are immune from all these pressures. They think that they can sustain with misfeasance, malfeasance, the corruption issues. They think that they owe no answerability, that they owe no accountability to the people, because they feel that they have been elected for 5 years. So they tend to sustain themselves despite conducting such unvirtuous or invirtuous actions. Now, from your mains examination point of view, what kind of a question can be asked on this? A question like, critically analyze the conduct of the public holders. So first of all, you must mention about what is meant by a public holder, what is expected from a public holder, and how the current public holders, they are aberrating from this path, and how there has been a transition in the way the people have been pursuing this democracy in India. And you must insert certain examples about the derelictions, about the corruption issues. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information about the classes, you can visit our website, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button and do share and comment on this video. And in case you have any sort of query about civil services preparation, you can WhatsApp me at 84594-0000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.